While tanks have been used for a variety of purposes during the over 100 years they have existed on the battlefield, one thing has remained largely the same, that being their ability to transport heavy firepower to the front lines. Whether this has been in the form of the lumbering landships of World War I or the MBTs of modern conflicts, this capability remains as one of, if not the, most important aspects of the tank. This raises the question, though, why has this not led to vehicles with more than one primary armament? While we previously discussed the problems with double-barrel tanks, that video did not go into the other possible answer to this question, multi-turreted tanks. Join me as we discuss the question of why multi-turreted tanks fail. Today's video is brought to you by my new merch store. Check out the store using the link in the description and get yourself designs based on vehicles like the Sherman Firefly, Matilda Frog, or iconic Doom Turtle, with more to come soon. Or if you'd rather get yourself some tank brick sets from Kobe, you can check out Warbricks USA, who I have partnered with, allowing you to save 5% on your orders using the code ConeOfArc5 while also supporting the channel. Links to both my merch and Warbricks USA will be in the description and pinned comment, and thanks to all of you who have already supported my work and helped me to be less reliant on YouTube ad revenue or sponsors to make this channel possible. Enough shilling though, let's talk tanks. The idea of having a multi-turreted tank has existed for as long as the tank itself. A number of these proposed designs can be found from 1916 onwards, with one of the most well-known being that of the Char 2C. This was designed right at the tail end of World War I, with a small handful being built several years later. However, over the years, this concept has been tried by many different nations, with mixed results. For the most part, these designs fall into a few categories. The most numerous of these is probably those featuring a larger turret housing a primary gun, with one or several smaller turrets fitted with smaller cannons or machine guns. The next type are those featuring two or more large turrets housing larger cannons. These are less common, but are likely the vehicles you will be more familiar with. Finally, we have what I consider the hybrid between the double-barrel tank and multi-turret tank concept. Many people were upset with me not including tanks such as the M3 Lee and Char B1 in my double-barrel video, as both were used in combat to varying degrees of success. However, in my opinion, while you could consider these to technically be double-barrel tanks, I think they also share quite a few characteristics with those of the multi-turreted tanks. For instance, the aforementioned examples both feature a hull-mounted cannon as well as a turret with another cannon. While truthfully they are a category of their own, I will likely refer back to this group of vehicles later in the video, as they saw more combat by far than the other two categories and suffered some of the same problems. Let's get back to our main question though. Why did multi-turreted tanks fail throughout history? The simple answer is that tanks with one turret are more cost-effective and perform better in combat, but you didn't click on this video for an answer like that. No, you want to hear a more detailed explanation of the various flaws with these designs, so let's get started with probably the biggest one, pun intended. As we discussed in the double barrel video, which you should really check out after this one, more guns on a tank will inevitably lead to the vehicle becoming larger. When it comes to multi-turreted tanks though, this becomes even more significant, as you are not only adding an additional gun to your tank, but an entire turret. This requires not just the turret itself, but a turret ring and enough space within the vehicle for the turret to be operated. Often this results in the tank becoming elongated, as we see with examples like the SMK or T-100. While they did provide additional firepower and could theoretically engage multiple targets simultaneously, in reality, this size led to a variety of problems. For one, the vehicle being larger means it requires more steel for the same level of armor protection, leading to a heavier vehicle. A perfect example of this is the SMK versus the KV-1, which both feature a similar hull design and armor. While the KV-1 comes in at around 45 tons, its larger cousin, the SMK, weighs 10 tons more at 55 tons. Adding an additional turret by itself already increases the size and therefore the weight, but additional space is also needed for ammunition and other equipment required for operating the turret and gun. You will also require more crew, meaning the manpower necessary to operate such a tank is significantly higher than single-turreted ones, ranging from around 7 to upwards of 12 in the Char 2C. This larger crew count, as well as other factors, leads to our next reason these vehicles fail, which also happens to be the name of a song by Led Zeppelin. While I'm not sure if this specific term has been used to reference this flaw with multi-turreted tanks, communication breakdown is a real issue which is bound to occur. This problem primarily occurs due to the number of crew within the vehicle compared to the sole commander of the vehicle. I imagine this would play out similarly to the situation of one-man turreted tanks, where the commander quickly becomes overburdened by the number of tasks required of him. Not only would he need to direct the driver as to where to go and watch for potential threats to the tank, he would also now need to direct not one, but two different turrets to engage targets. While in a modern setting this could likely be simplified with the help of technology, this cannot be said for earlier examples. This problem is potentially easier to remedy as you could simply have a second commander for the other turret rather than have one commander direct both, but this brings with it problems of its own. As a hypothetical, imagine this is the case and you are the commander of a multi-turreted tank. You wish for your driver to move through an area of dense woodland, but whilst doing so, unbeknownst to you, the crew within the other turret spots and attempts to engage a threat. Before you have a chance to react, this results in the barrel of said turret slamming side-on into a tree. While this may be a somewhat hyperbolic example, having multiple turrets would almost certainly result in a decrease in the crew's ability to react to combat scenarios. Even assuming the second turret commander always verified orders with the tank commander, this would still add another thing for him to worry about while slowing down the ability of the other turret crew in engaging targets. This is likely a less significant concern compared to the window sticker price of such a tank, though.
Money, oh money, how I love thee!
The issue of cost is partially tied to the overall size of the vehicle, but despite what you might initially be thinking, this is not just referring to the dollar cost of a vehicle. No, a multi-turreted tank would not just cost more money to produce, but would also require a larger amount of raw materials and, most critically, an increase in man-hours to produce it. While I do not have specific figures for the man-hours it took to build particular multi-turreted tanks, I think it is safe to assume that it is higher than single-turreted vehicles. A lengthened hull by itself would not require that much more time to produce, but manufacturing multiple turrets would inevitably require additional man-hours for both the other turrets as well as their guns and internal components. Considering that for this larger bill and longer manufacturing time, you end up with a vehicle with only marginally better firepower as well as the previously mentioned drawbacks, and this also reducing the number of vehicles you can produce in the same time period, it becomes hard to justify such a design. Even if we ignore all of this, does a tank with two or more guns really provide any benefits?
I can explain.
While it is fairly easy to point out the flaws of these multi-turreted landships, it's only fair that we also consider the theoretical benefits of such a design, and there are a few. Obviously, the main benefit is that such a vehicle would provide more firepower over a single turreted tank. Though this is undeniably true, as more guns equals more boom, the same can be said for simply building more tanks. This is particularly true for vehicles which are going to be shipped overseas, and we can see an example of this with the US M6 heavy tank. Although it isn't a multi-turreted tank, the M6 was similarly pushed aside in favor of lighter vehicles like the M4 Sherman, which could be shipped in greater numbers. After all, why have one tank with multiple guns when you can have more tanks, each with their own guns, bringing roughly the same amount of firepower? Another potential benefit a multi-turreted tank could provide over a traditional tank could be a psychological one. Surely a vehicle firing off numerous cannons and machine guns would cause more fear in the enemy troops facing off against it, right? One study on American troops wounded in North Africa does indicate that things like dive bombing and 88mm cannon fire were feared over most other weapons, and while tanks specifically weren't on this list, the reasons soldiers found those intimidating could easily parallel a tank. However, again, would a single multi-turreted tank provide more terror on a soldier or bolster friendly forces significantly more than a regular tank or multiple regular tanks could? Another thing multi-turreted tanks have going for them comes with the designs featuring additional turrets on the sides or rear armed with machine guns. These would help protect the tank from enemy infantry by eliminating blind spots and cutting down attackers. In a trench warfare scenario, like many expected following World War I, you can understand why this would have been seen as important since tanks were likely to be the main method of breaking through enemy lines. This is one benefit I do have to give the multi-turreted tank over a single turreted tank, though once again, multiple tanks can also solve this. One final benefit I will touch on is one which I can't say I've actually seen as a stated requirement for a multi-turreted tank, but I could see being a theoretical benefit. In theory, a multi-turreted tank could be used as a sort of breakthrough infantry carrier where upon reaching a strategic location, some of the crew could then dismount, leaving a still operational tank to support them. Realistically though, you can get the same benefits of this by simply using combined arms tactics rather than relying on a single vehicle to do everything. This also adds to the previous problems we discussed, such as potentially increasing the size of the vehicle further to accommodate additional soldiers, which in turn either requires sacrificing armor or adding more weight, resulting in a vicious cycle of increasing weight at the cost of mobility. Despite any of these potential benefits, the drawbacks of such a design have repeatedly caused multi-turret designs to be abandoned in favor of more traditional tanks. Tanks like the Char 2C may have made for fantastic propaganda vehicles for the French, but they had no impact during the invasion of France outside of giving the invading Germans propaganda shots of their own. Even designs like the Vickers A1E1 Independent, which is in many ways a common ancestor to a multitude of tanks from around the world, would not be adopted by the British military. The only designs which can loosely be described as multi-turreted tanks to have seen any true level of success are vehicles like the M3 Lee or the Crusaders, which featured small turrets for their hull machine guns. Even these, however, would inevitably be replaced by designs which did away with these additional armaments or found better ways to implement them. The closest thing we are likely to see to the multi-turreted tanks of the past in future tank designs are things like the Crow's system mounted to MBTs. I personally believe these are likely to see increased development to combat drone attacks as part of the active protection systems tanks already feature. Even these, though, are just further developments on roof machine guns and not the return of multi-turreted vehicles, even if they technically could fit the definition. But what do you think about both the past and future of multi-turreted tanks? Do you think we will ever see a return of these outlandish vehicles, or are they simply relics of the interwar period? Let me know in the comments, and let me know if you think there are any flaws or benefits to them which you think I might have missed. Thanks, as always, to my Conley fans for their support of my work. I greatly appreciate it. You can become one today by using the join button below or support the channel by buying some merch as I mentioned at the start of the video. If you enjoyed this video, I highly recommend checking out my previous video on why double-barrel tanks have failed in the past and continue to not be adopted. Or if you've already seen that one, YouTube thinks you'll like this video instead. Hope to see you there.